Now, a much-loved local returned home today after being gone for decades. Kiwi used to be plentiful in the Kaitake ranges near Mount Taranaki until their population was decimated by predators.
Now, thanks to a massive effort to get pest numbers down, kiwi are finally returning home. Here's Carolyn Robinson.
Graham Churchill's a bird man.
Yes, everything I plant's got to be for the birds. It's got to either have a fruit or a flower. It's the way I operate.
Back when his neck didn't give him trouble, Graham and wife Laurel were farmers, and they clearly remember hearing kiwi in the hills above their home.
We were farming up there in 1968, and the farm bordered onto the ranges, and we'd hear them at nights.
It was just nice. We just listened to them whistle to each other. Gosh, these are old photos, Graham.
That's Big Ridge, that's the tower.
That's where we heard them then.
Back then, the sound was familiar, frequent, and fearless.
Yeah, we took it for granted a bit, actually.
And then, gradually, they heard them less and less.
We used to comment, Laurel, didn't we? We're not hearing the kiwis.
The why was obvious.
There's not a more ratty place in the country than Taranaki. We track at between 90 and 100% racks every time we put a detection device up there. Before we got started in here, it was a pretty grim state of affairs.
The best chance for Taranaki kiwi lay further south at the Rotokari Scenic Reserve, a 230-hectare bird sanctuary near Eltham.
It's predator-free, so it's got an 8-kilometre fence around it. We even eradicated mice.
Kiwi have flourished here.
A recent survey showed there were probably over 262.
And so, with help from the Taranaki Kiwi Trust and a massive community effort to turn the tables on predators, kiwi can finally go back to Kaitake.
We know we're on the right track because we're using a lot of cameras in our project now, and we very rarely detect a stoat or a ferret on the camera. We know they're there. We also know we've got a whole lot more effort in there catching them.
Today's release is kohai.
This one's about 2 kilograms in weight, so it's plenty big enough that if there was a stoat or something else in this part of the bush, it's big enough to fend itself, look after itself and fend that stoat off.
Even so, she goes with the hopes and prayers of an entire community. Her new location, deep in native bush, is one her ancestors knew well.
Beautiful, yeah, it's amazing, yeah. Very special place. Very special place.
Tāne te wānanga, tāne te waiora, tāne te pūkenga, tāne te wakaputa nei ki te waiao, ki te ao mārama. A koiara e rongo, wakahiri a ke kironga, turuturu o uti waka maua, kia tīnā, tīnā, hui e tāki.
Never seen one before.
I think she would be very happy, because we have a beautiful forest here.
This is their home, this is where they're meant to be. There's 7 other kiwi out there waiting for her to join them. They should yell at each other later tonight and work out who's who.
The Churchills will be listening out.
Yeah, they're iconic, aren't they? We're called kiwis, aren't we?
Our namesake's back.
Oh, hell, great, absolutely. Marvellous. Yeah.
Haere mai kohai. Welcome home.
Oh, and she was big too.